Rabbi Crisp, a recent article in a scientific journal proposed bringing a woolly mammoth back to life by taking its DNA and recreating somewhat similar to the dinosaurs in Jurassic Park. So in some sense, is this the resurrection of the dead, Tchiyat HaMetim? Is this perhaps how Hashem will bring humans back to life when Mashiach comes?
I'm aware of that particular project, but it's not by any stretch of the imagination the first of its kind. Already a number of years ago, petrified seeds were found near Masada in Israel, of a plant species that's believed to have been extinct for 1,000 years. They were able to extract a reasonably good, intact sample of their DNA and through an elaborate process boot them up into new living cells. And for the last 5 or odd years, those plants are now growing again. An even further example, they took an extinct lion that had been in a jar for the last 100 years or so in a university laboratory. We're also able to extract its DNA and to get an embryo going through gestesis inside the womb of a mouse. I guess it would have been the mouse that roared if it could have carried it to full term. It could not, but it is the first example of an animal actually starting to grow biologically that had been extinct for a significant period of time. And what all this points to is a notion that in the Messianic age, many of these things that historically would have been regarded as miraculous will become part of our expanded understanding of nature. That nature itself will be unified with God above nature. The two will become one. Hashem, Hu Elokim. We say God who is above nature is equivalent and one and the same with God as nature. God is identical with the laws of nature, even though God also transcends them. And so we will see that this is part of the fabric of the universe, that things come back. And this is just the beginning. It's going to get wild from here.
Thank you very much.